welcome to another episode of Drilling Deeper. My name is Christina, and I'm the Education Coordinator here at the Oil Museum of Canada. Today, we're going to look at this particular object. Now, this object has a lot of story and myth attached to it. It's not just what it appears to be. So what does it appear to be right on the surface? Well, this is a drilling bit. In particular, this is a tricorn drilling bit. So we call it that because it has three parts to it, these rotary motor bits. These teeth would actually grind and chew up the rock as it went down the wellbore. Now, we also see that on the top, it's got a hole in it. Drilling mud or fluid would be pumped down through that hole to lubricate the tool. This was really important and a great and huge innovation for the oil industry. So that mud or fluid would come down, it would cool the bit as it was grinding up the rock because it heats up. And what it would do is it would float all of the debris that had just been chewed up back to the surface because there was continual pressure of that fluid coming down the shaft and then it would float the mud back up, containing all of the bits and debris, and simultaneously cooling and lubricating this drill head. This was invented by Howard Hughes Sr. and patented by Howard Hughes Jr. in 1933. That's particularly important. So this is a Baker-Hughes bit. We know that because we've talked to people and we confirmed that yes, this model number, and it has all sorts of different markings on the top that we were able to trace. So why does that matter that this is a Baker-Hughes bit and that it was donated here to the museum? Well, there's a story that goes along with that. So in 1960, when the museum opened, this was the brand new Oil Museum of Canada, and a big black Cadillac kicked up a lot of dust and came wheeling into the museum, and a slightly disheveled, interesting looking man got out and plopped this artifact on the curator's desk. She was working the front desk that day and said, "This is a gift from Howard Hughes." And Howard Hughes is a very important person. Not only is he the one that patented this, he was a very famous person. He made movies, he dated Hollywood actresses. He was very much involved in the aviation industry and invented many different aircrafts and set world speed records for those aircrafts. In fact, there was a movie that was made not too long ago starring Leonardo DiCaprio about his life and times. So how do we think and assume, just because somebody plopped it on our desk, that this was from Howard Hughes? Well, the story goes, and this is the myth of the museum that's been passed down from curator to museum staff throughout the years since 1960, is that this black Cadillac came in. The curator, being a very careful person that she was, recorded the license plate number. She recorded that license plate number and the story of the person that donated it, suspectedly Howard Hughes, and checked with the local OPP detachment. Sure enough, they were able to trace that car as being rented in Detroit, Michigan, and registered to the Baker Hughes Company. Well, this gave it a little bit more weight because Howard Hughes was in Detroit, Michigan, just slightly over the border and not too far away from the museum. He would have easily had time to cross the border and donate this artifact, having one of his drill bits in a museum of quite importance. So we've passed this story down, and this is the mystery of Howard Hughes. Now, why is it important that we know that the man who donated it was slightly disheveled looking? Well, in Howard Hughes's later life, he suffered from many ailments due to his accidents while flying airplanes. He crashed his airplanes, and it was assumed that he had OCD, which is obsessive compulsive disorder, as well as many other ailments that caused him pain from his plane crashes. So these things would have all contributed to the description that our curator was able to track down, the confirmation that the car came from the United States and was registered to the Baker Hughes Company, and the time frame, because Howard Hughes was still alive at this time period and traveling the North America. So this artifact is in our collection. It is from, we assume, Howard Hughes, the man who invented and patented this and made his millions so that he is now a part of our pop culture. And we quite love this artifact, not just because of the story it tells about the history of the oil business and the fact that it was related to actually drilling for oil, but its other existential myth that we have about how do we acquire objects and the stories that surround these objects. Now, I want you to like our channel and leave some comments below. I love feedback. So if you have anything else you would like to add to the story or questions or concerns you may have, please feel to let us know. We would love to hear from you and see you here at the Oil Museum of Canada in Oil Springs.